Welcome back, everyone, to another Dicon Dissectional production hosted by Deathstroke9. Today, we're going to be reacting to, but also lyrically analyzing, Billy Joel, We Didn't Start the Fire. Hey, everyone. All right, so the name of the song sounds very familiar to me, so it's highly likely that I've heard at least part of it before, so I'm just going to say that disclaimer right at the beginning. Never paid any attention to the lyrics, don't really remember what any of the music sounds like, so we're going to react to it anyway, but I'm not going to put first listen or whatever like I normally do in the description or in the title. So just letting you know, disclaimer, probably have heard part of this song before. We're going to be analyzing it, trying to figure out what it means, figure out what it's talking about. You know, this is a Patreon request. Thank you for requesting this and welcome to the channel. My name is Daniel, also Deathstroke9. And here we try to react to music. I try to figure out what it means to me personally, and then you guys let me know what it means to you. It's all a great time. So, if that sounds interesting, consider subscribing to the channel. Now, I thought it would be a good idea to pull up the official video because, you know, if I've heard part of the song before, then at least a video is something new that I haven't seen before, right? Plus, it had 103 million views on YouTube, which is just insane. All right, let's do this. 3, 2, 1, Billy Joel, We Didn't Start the Fire. Let's go. Sorry, gotta pause it at least once or else YouTube will take these videos down. It's highly likely. Last time I tried to do Billy Joel, it got taken down anyway. Let's take a look at this. Harry Truman. Doris Day. I don't know all these people, actually. Let's look them up. Let's look these things up one by one, shall we? Let's try to figure out everything. Harry Truman. 33rd President of the United States. All right. I knew that one. Doris Day. American actress, singer, and American welfare activist. She began her career as a big band singer, achieving commercial success in 1945. Sentimental Journey and My Dreams Are Getting Better All the Time. Never heard of Doris Day before. Red China. Would that be Communist China? Oops. Let's see. May refer to communist-controlled China, okay? Johnny Ray, that name sounds familiar. American singer, songwriter, and pianist. Highly popular for most of the 1950s, Ray has been cited by critics as a major precursor to what became rock and roll for his jazz and blues-influenced music and his animated stage personality. All right, cool. South Pacific, well, that would be an ocean, right? Or is there like a war or something specific? Oh, it's a musical. Okay, South Pacific is a musical composed by Richard Rodgers with lyrics by Oscar Hammerstein II and book by Hammerstein and Joshua Logan. The work premiered on Broadway was an immediate hit. Huh. Okay. Or it's an area of from the top of Australia to the Hawaiian Islands, some 11 million square miles, vast and blue, but Let's see. So far it's been all, or mostly all, pop culture references with the exception of the president. All right, syndicated American newspaper, gossip columnist, and radio news commentator. So he's going through the years in this song. He began his newspaper career as a Broadway reporter, critic, and columnist for New York tabloids. Joe DiMaggio. His name sounds very familiar. Who was this? Baseball. Yep, knew it. Jolton Joe, the Yankee Clipper, was an American baseball center fielder who played his entire 13-year career in Major League Baseball for the New York Yankees. Alrighty. And we've got more. We've got a lot to go through, guys. Let's bear with me. Let's try to, I want to understand this song. Another politician, World War II, Distinguished Flying Cross. It was an American politician who served as a Republican senator in the state of Wisconsin. Okay, so. Interesting. Wait, what did that say? Wait. Let me go back. Sorry. What stopped McCarthyism? He is known for stating allegations that numerous communist and Soviet spies and sympathizers had infiltrated the United States government. Ultimately, the smear tactics that he used led him to be censored by the U.S. Senate. It's the practice of making accusations of subversion or treaty without proper regard for evidence. Okay, so he was famous because he... just said a bunch of stuff with no evidence to back his claims. Okay. Richard Nixon? Well, we know who that is, but let's see what this has to say about it anyway. All right. 37th President of the United States... served as vice president before that, rose to prominence as a representative and senator of California. All right. Studebaker. That sounds kind of familiar. American wagon and automobile manufacturer. All righty. A producer of wagons, buggies, carriages, and harnesses. We're learning a lot today. Television. Okay, we know what that is. We don't need to look that up. North Korea, South Korea. Okay, we know what that is. Marilyn Monroe, that's an actress, right? Very famous actress. Marilyn Monroe. Famous for playing comedic blonde bombshell characters, she became one of the most popular sex symbols of the 1950s and early 60s and was emblematic of the era's changing attitudes towards sexuality. Didn't she also have, like, a horrible life, though? Or didn't... I don't know. Did she, like... Do we not know how she died? I don't remember. There's something weird about her... character, or her as a person. At least I think. Maybe I don't know. Yeah, I might not know. Let's continue. Rosenbergs. All right, we know what an H-bomb is. Hydrogen bomb. Rosenbergs were the first U.S. citizens to be convicted and executed for espionage during peacetime, and their case remains controversial to this day. He was an engineer for the Army Corps who was born in New York. He was killed, death by the electric chair, convicted of spying for the Soviet Union in one of the most sensational trials. So sensationalism. They were both killed for their role in passing atomic secrets to the Soviets during and after World War II. Interesting. Sugar Ray. Who's that? Man, there's so much going on in this song. Look at this. We've been talking for a while. We only got through like 1 minute of it. There's so much going on. All right, American rock band. This came out in that time period. Sugar Ray. What happened? Boxer. There we go. Not... this music. This makes more sense. Considered one of the greatest boxers of all time, Sugar Ray Robinson held the world welterweight title from 1946 to 1951, and by 1958, he had become the first boxer to win a divisional world championship 5 times. Let me know if Sugar Ray is supposed to be about the nu metal band, which I highly, highly doubt, or the boxer from the 1950s. Much more likely. Whatever this word is, it's the building where the armistice was signed. Armistice. whatever. That word. Okay. That's good. Or interesting. Brando. The King and I and Catcher in the Rye. Okay. I know what Catcher in the Rye is. Not entirely sure if I know what The King and I is. Marlon Brando. Okay, so that's who he's talking about here. That makes sense. The King and I. Search. Fifth musical by a team of composer Richard Rodgers and dramatist Oscar Hammerstein. Another Hammerstein thing. Huh. Okay. Catcher in the Rye, we know what that is. Or I would have said, I'll check it anyway, just to make this video as educational as possible. We're going to learn what every single reference from this song could possibly be. All right, The Catcher in the Rye is a novel by J.D. Salinger, partially published in serial form in 1945 to 1946, and as a novel in 1951. It was originally intended for adults, but is often read by adolescents for its themes of angst and alienation, and as a critique on superficiality in society, it has been translated widely. Yes, it has a lot of... Yeah, I know that book. Eisenhower. We know who that is, but we're going to check it anyway. Dwight D. Eisenhower. I like Ike. As an American Army general who served as the 34th President of the United States from 1953 to 1961. During World War II, he became a 5-star general in the Army and served as Supreme Commander of the Allied Expeditionary Force in Europe. All right? Vaccines. I'm pretty sure everyone knows what that is, especially right now. England's got a new queen. Elizabeth becomes Queen of England. All right. See results about we didn't start the fire. Yep. Marciano. According to this, it's woman's clothing line. Liberace, I know who that is. I think he was... Yeah. Very flamboyant pianist, correct? Was an American pianist, singer, and actor, child prodigy. Born in Wisconsin to parents of Italian and Polish origin, he enjoyed a career spanning 4 decades of concerts, recordings, television, motion pictures, and endorsements. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. He did a lot of stuff. I know about him because there's a book I really like called A Prayer for Owen Meany. You should check out that book if you haven't already. It was one of the most adulty books I ever read, but very interesting how it worked. And anyway, at one point Liberace comes into it. He died. How did he die? Stomach cancer. Okay. I don't know what this is. Rosenberg's Through Santiana Goodbye. Let me know what this one means if you can. Then where we didn't start the fire, it was always burning since the world's been turning. Oh, we didn't start the fire. No, we didn't light it, but we tried to fight it. Now, where are we? Oh, yeah, we went through this one as well. So, let's keep going. Joseph Stalin. Okay, just in case anyone doesn't know who Joseph Stalin is, or Stalin, whatever. Georgian revolutionary Soviet politician who ruled the Soviet Union in the mid-1920s until his death in 1953. He served as the General Secretary of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union and Premier of the Soviet Union as well. All right. Malenkov. Thank you for making this song, Billy Joel. He was a Soviet politician who briefly succeeded Joseph Stalin. Okay. Nasser, I can't pronounce all these names. Egyptian president. All right. Rockefeller Center. Rockefeller. Or a person, okay. He's an American business magnate and philanthropist. He's widely considered the wealthiest American of all time. And the richest person in modern history. Huh. Good for him. Campanella. Campanella. Let's see. All right. Is Italian for little bell? Roy Campanella. Another baseball player. All right. American baseball player. Philadelphia native. Played in the Negro Leagues and the Mexican League for 9 years before entering the minor leagues in 1946. All right. Communist bloc. There's so many references in this song. Wow. The Eastern Bloc, also known as the Communist Bloc, Socialist Bloc, and the Soviet Bloc, was a group of communist states of Central and Eastern Europe under the hegemony of the Soviet Union, USSR, that existed during the Cold War. Roy. I want to. Yeah, wow. There's so much going on in this song. Roy Kahn was an American lawyer, best known for being a senator. He was Joseph McCarthy's chief counsel during the army. I apologize if this video seems like it's going on really long. I'm trying to educate myself on what the song is talking about. I don't know all of these references. President of Argentina is Jan Perón. I can't pronounce his name, sorry. Toscanini. He was an Italian conductor. He became one of the most acclaimed musicians of the late 19th and 20th century, renowned for his intensity. Oh, that's pretty cool. Dacron. What is polyester fiber type thing? Dean Bean Foo Falls. Something like that. French-held garrison in Vietnam fell after a four-month siege led by Vietnamese nationalist Ho Chi Minh. After the fall, the French pulled out of the region. Okay. Rock Around the Clock. Bill Haley and the Comets. Okay. I've heard at least one song by them. They're very famous group. Einstein, we know who that is. James Dean, we should know who that is, but just in case, we're going to search anyway. James Dean was an American actor. He's remembered as a cultural icon of teenage disillusionment and social estrangement, as expressed in the title of his most celebrated film, Rebel Without a Cause, in which he starred as the troubled teenager Jim Stark. That's interesting.
Sounds like a cool guy.
Also, in case you didn't know, Einstein is a famous scientist. You know, E equals mc squared and all that. Brooklyn's got a winning team. 1955, the Brooklyn Dodgers win the World Series at last, beating the New York Yankees. Wow, finally. The Yankees win a lot. Davy Crockett, we should know who that is, but we're going to check anyway. Some people might not. I know who that is. David Crockett was an American folk hero, frontiersman, soldier, and politician. He's commonly referred to in popular culture by King of the Wild Frontier. Peter Pan is a story about a flying boy who fights a pirate. Elvis Presley is Elvis Presley. You know, a very famous singer who kind of brought in this kind of bluesy and rock and roll-y type of, and he did weird dances and sang in a weird way. He was an icon. He had the hair. Very interesting character. Disneyland. It's Disneyland. That would be where Mickey Mouse lives. Mickey Mouse lives with his wife Minnie in that place. Bardot, another women's clothing and accessories place. Budapest. Alabama is apparently something that came into existence at this time. It's the capital and most populous city of Hungary. Hungary? Something like that. It's bisected by the River Danube. Whoa. I actually did a research paper on this city. Or actually, Hungary itself. Like, the whole... It was interesting. There was a lot to go into it. Alabama. I don't know why. Is there something specific about it? It's Southeastern U.S. state that's home to significant landmarks from this American civil rights movement. Okay, apparently a lot of things happened in the past couple of hours. Stop saying things I can't pronounce, Mr. Joel. Yeah, look at this name. Nikita, here's me trying to pronounce this. Nikita Sergeyevich Khrushchev was a Soviet politician who led the Soviet Union during a part of the Cold War as the first secretary of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union from 1953 to 1964 and as chairman of the Council of Ministers from 1958 to 1964. I didn't know what I was going to be in for when I started this. I think I'm changing the title of the video. We try to figure out every single reference in this song. Princess Grace. Grace Patricia Kelly, also known as Grace of Monaco, was an American film actress who, after starring in several significant films, became Princess of Monaco by marrying Prince Rainer III. Okay. Peyton Place, probably another book or play. TV series, never mind. Like the novel and film of the same name, this nighttime soap opera is set in the small town of New England, Peyton Place, whose quaint charm masks a complicated web of extramarital affairs, shady business deals, scandals, and even murder. Sounds fun. Sounds like a great show. One that we should all watch together. One that's just fun for the whole family. Let's keep going. Trouble in the Suez. The Suez Crisis, or the Second Arab-Israeli War, was also called the tripartite aggression in the Arab world and Sinai War in Israel. It was an invasion of Egypt in late 1956 by Israel, followed by the United Kingdom and France. Where are we? Did we make it past this? I don't remember. Then we got back to the main course. We didn't start the fire. So he's just going through all the things that I'll bet he, Billy Joel, remembers happening kind of in his lifetime. All these crazy things that are going on. Alright, I'm gonna say we stopped there. We're only halfway through the song. This is how well Billy Joel was able to make songs. He was able to make a song that you could sit and research for 25 minutes and only be done with half of it. Let's keep going. 3, 2, 1, Billy Joel, We Didn't Start the Fire. Team Davy Crockett, Peter Pan, Elvis Presley, Disneyland. Sally Ride. Billy Joel look different in that. Go ahead and like this. So, my interpretation of this, I'm going to go through every single reference that he makes, okay? So, if you don't want to stay, like, I realize that this is probably grating to listen to. So, if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. We do reactions mostly. But yeah, so he's just kind of showing how quickly everything's moving, especially recently with the immersion of the internet. Our information has begun to, you know, mesh together. We've gotten a hold of a lot of topics and concepts. And because of that, we are starting to take bigger strides forward as a society. There are always going to be people, well, maybe not always, but right now there are still people who want to try and hold things back. There are things that should stay the same, and there are things that should change. And change is coming. Let's hope that we're all here to see it. All right. If you're still here, let's dive deep. Let me make this a little bit bigger, so maybe you can actually read what's going on over here. In fact, do you need to see me at all? We can just do this. It's only right. Makes sense. All right. Here we go. We're going to keep going. We were here. Little Rock. That's where we're at. Let's see what this is. Search Google for Little Rock. Little Rock, Arkansas. What is Little Rock famous for? It's best known around the world for the crucial role it played in American civil rights history after 9 African-American students enrolled were denied entry, causing a national crisis. Yes. All right. Pasternak. So lots of political... Well, that's not really political. That's human rights. But there have been a lot of references to politics in this song. Boris Pasternak was a Russian poet, novelist, and literary translator. And this song was obviously influenced very much by the Cold War and the tensions, the nuclear tension between Russia or the USSR and America, and like the space race and the fact that we were all trying to, you know, we were threatening each other with nuclear weapons. Okay, Mickey Mantle, another baseball player. Lots of baseball players. He was nicknamed the Commerce Comet, and the Mick was an American professional baseball player. He played his entire Major League Baseball career with the New York Yankees as a center fielder, right fielder, and first baseman. Going to bet that maybe Billy Joel's from New York. Kerouac. It was a writer who was a leading figure of the Beat Generation. He was an American novelist of French-Canadian ancestry who, alongside William S. Burroughs and Allen Ginsberg, was a pioneer of the Beat Generation. I don't even know what the Beat Generation is. Oh, a beatnik and a hippie. Okay. Member of the Beat Generation of poets, or a person inspired by the Beat poets. What the frick is this question right here? Just wondering. Why is it called the Beat Generation? It was an underground anti-conformist youth movement. All right, cool. Sputnik. There's the space race we were looking for. All right, so that's when they got up into space. The first artificial Earth satellite, the Soviet Union launched it in an elliptical low Earth orbit on the 4th of October, 1957. Maybe I should say the rest of this in a British accent. It's also a horror-slash-thriller movie that came out in 2020, but that's not really that important. Alright, next is Chow and Lai. Something like that. Zhao and Lai. Okay, they got it slightly wrong. It was a communist leader and premier of the People's Republic of China. He was... Oh, wait a minute, I remember this guy. I learned a bit about him. Alright, let's just move on. Bridge over the River Kwai. Let's see what we've got over here. It was a British-American adventure epic war film directed by David Lean and based on the 1952 novel written by Pierre somebody. The film uses the historical setting of the construction of the Burma Railway in 1942 to 1943. Lebanon, we should know what that is, but or at least I know what that is already, but let's take a look at it anyway. Oh wow, there's things going on recently. Lebanon, officially known as the Lebanese Republic, is a country in Western Asia. It's bordered by Syria to the north and east and Israel to the south, while Cyprus lies west across the Mediterranean Sea. Whatever that word is. It was a French army officer. Sorry, I'm American and I cannot pronounce a lot of your things that you have. He was best known for... He led the Free French forces in resisting capitulation to Germany during World War II and became provincial president of France in the immediate aftermath of the war. Later, he was the architect of the... was an architect of the Fifth Republic and was president from 1958 to 1969. He was apparently sentenced to death. He made speeches on BBC Radio... What? Oh, he was sentenced to death, but he never died. Okay. Interesting. Well, he did eventually, I would assume, die. Yes, he died on November 9th, 1970. All right. According to Wikipedia, California baseball... makes it different from normal. All right, the California Golden Bears baseball team? Huh. All right, I don't... interesting. Maybe they didn't have baseball back then in California. Starkweather. Charles Starkweather was an American spree killer who murdered 11 people in Nebraska and Wyoming between December 1957 and January 1958 when he was 19 years old. He killed 10 of his victims between January 21st and January 29th, 1958, the date of his arrest. All right, so he killed one person, then like a year later he went on a much longer spree or whatever. How did he die? Capital punishment. Makes sense. Homicide. Apparently that was a new thing now. Homicide wasn't there before this time period. The act of one human killing another. Children of the Thalamide. What? That sounds like a cult. It's not a cult. It can treat and prevent a skin disease caused by leprosy. What it was the children... The drug that had been prescribed to many pregnant women in order to relieve pregnancy nausea was later found out that it caused irreversible damages to the fetus, and thousands of children were born with severe congenital malformations. That's horrible. Oh my goodness gracious. I did not know that. Buddy Holly? Know who he is, but we're gonna check it anyway. Ben-Hur, I've seen that movie before. Or at least an animated version of it. Alright, Charles Hardin Holly, known professionally as Buddy Holly, was an American musician and singer-songwriter who was a central and pioneering figure of mid-1950s rock and roll. We keep going back and forth between the 60s and the 50s. Ben-Hur was, you know, a epic historical drama directed by William Wyler, produced, it's not necessarily... It is a... Yeah, Ben-Hur is a story of a fictional hero named Judah Ben-Hur, a Jewish nobleman who was falsely accused and convicted of an attempted assassination of the Roman governor of Judea and consequently enslaved by the Romans. He becomes a successful charioteer. Space monkey. Oh, is that when they threw monkeys into space, huh? Apparently there's a... Oh, okay, well... Interesting. What is the space monkey? Lots of different things are coming up here, but none of that is what I'm looking for. Alright. November... Yeah, alright. There was a monkey sent into space. That's space monkey. Mafia! Let's find out what the Mafia could possibly be. It's a type of organized crime syndicate. Who would have thought? Hula hoops. If you don't know what those are, you've got a problem. Yes, hula hoops are, things that you spin around your waist. Castro. Not to be confused with castration. Fidel Castro was a Cuban revolutionary and politician who served as Prime Minister of Cuba from 1959 to 1976. Ideologically Marxist / Leninist, okay, and Cuban nationalist. He served as first secretary of the Communist Party of Cuba, wow, until 2011. Interesting. Ed still is a no-go. Alright, something, whatever that is, didn't work out. Why was the Edsel such a failure? It was an expensive car that used up too much gas and was mocked in the press. The damage was done, and he went so far to blame the American public for the failed launch. Alright, interesting. U2, I'm assuming that would be the group. Yeah, Irish rock band from Dublin, formed in 1976. Singman Rhee. South Korean politician who served as the first president of South Korea. He was also the first and last president of the provincial government of the Republic of Korea from 1992. His impeachment in 1925. Why was he impeached? Interesting. Alrighty then, let's continue. Paola and Kennedy. Wonder what this could be about. Alright, in the music industry is the illegal practice of payment commercial radio in which the song is presented as being part of the normal day's broadcast without announcing that there has been consideration paid in cash or in kind for its airplay adjacent to the recording's broadcast. The scandal was during hearings conducted. Okay, quiz show rigging. Alright. Interesting. There's a lot of stuff in there. We know who Kennedy is. Chubby Checker. Who's that? An American rock and roll singer and dancer is widely known for popularizing many dance styles, including the twist dance style with his 1960 hit cover of Hank Ballard and the Midnighters R&B hit The Twist, and the pony with the hit Pony Time. Righty. Psycho, I think it was a book and also multiple movies. Alright, it's a film. Psycho is an American psychological thriller produced and directed by Alfred Hitchcock, one of my favorite directors. The screenplay written by Joseph Stefano was based off the novel of the same name by Robert Bloch. What? I'm sorry, I did not know. Robert, he was one of the... Not necessarily one of the, Lovecraft Circle, but technically kind of was, and I'm a fan of Lovecraft's work, or at least some of his work. Belgians in the Congo. The Belgian Congo was a Belgian colony in Central Africa until it became independent, alright? So it achieved its independence in 1960. We didn't start the fire. It's been burning since the world's been turning on and on and on and on. Hemingway, let's look up that. What does this mean? American journalist, novelist, short story writer, and sportsman. His economical and understated style, which he termed the iceberg theory, has had strong influence in 20th century fiction, while his adventurous lifestyle and his public image brought him admiration from later generations. That's interesting. His understated style, which he termed the iceberg theory. So maybe, tip of the iceberg? That's a very interesting, just reading that. I don't know anything about him, but just that little snippet is very interesting. Adolf... Okay. He was one of the major organizers of the Holocaust, apparently. The final solution... No, I'm not even going to say that. Wow. That's horrible. All right. Stranger in a Strange Land. Science fiction novel by American author Robert A. Heinlein. It tells the story of Valentine Michael Smith, a human who comes to Earth in early adulthood after being probably abducted or something along those lines. Dylan. That'd be Bob Dylan. Bob Dylan. Berlin. Berlin Wall. Bay of Pigs invasion. Assuming you could call it an invasion. An abortive invasion of Cuba. The invasion was financed and directed by the U.S. government. Lawrence of Arabia. Let's look up what this could possibly mean. It's a British epic historical drama film based on the life of T.E. Lawrence. It was directed by David Lean and produced by Sam Spiegel through his British company Horizon Pictures. British Beatlemania. Would that be the British invasion? Beatlemania was the intense fan frenzy surrounding the English rock band The Beatles. The band's popularity grew in the United Kingdom throughout 1963, propelled by the singles Please Please Me, From Me to You, and She Loves You. All very generic names, but you know. Ole Miss. What does this mean? It just looks like University of Mississippi. Huh. Interesting. John Glenn? What do we got over here? John Glenn Jr. was a United States Marine Corps aviator, engineer, astronaut, businessman, and politician. Liston beats Patterson. They win a boxing match for the title of World Heavyweight Champion, 1962. Pope Paul. Malcolm X. He was the head of Catholic Church and sovereign of the city-state from the Vatican city-state. From 21st of June 1963 to his death in 1978. Malcolm X, we should know who that is, but if you don't. He was an African-American Muslim minister and human rights activist who was a popular figure during the Civil War movement. He is best known for his time spent as a vocal spokesman for the Nation of Islam. Huh. Interesting. We don't need to look that one up. British politician sex. Bunch of scandals. Pretty clear. John F. Kennedy, often referred to by his initials JFK and Jack, was an American politician who served as the 35th President of the United States from January 1961 until his assassination on November 1963. Blown away? What else have I got to say? Blown away, who would that be? Would that be... not Carrie Underwood. I would assume that might be about World War II, maybe? No, we were already in the... We've been mostly not talking about World War II, we've been talking about the Cold War. We're almost through. Birth control. Oh, this is when birth control was regulated, I would assume. Interesting. Yeah, we know what that means. Ho Chi Minh was a Vietnamese revolutionary and politician. He served as the Prime Minister of Vietnam from 1945 to 1955. The song is so educational. Richard Nixon back again. Alright, he continued with what he was doing. Moonshot. It's funny how this all rhymes. The act of, or instance of launching a spacecraft to the moon. Good job, everybody. Woodstock. We all know what Woodstock is. On this channel, we should know what Woodstock is. It's a music festival held August 15th to 18th, 1969. 3 days of peace and music. The Woodstock Rock Festival. It attracted an audience of over 400,000 people. Insane. Watergate. The Watergate scandal was a political scandal in the United States involving the administration of U.S. President Richard Nixon that led up to Nixon's resignation. His punishment for it was, former CIA officer and FBI agent convicted on 8 counts of conspiracy, burglary, and wiretapping was sentenced to 25 years in prison, reduced to 1 to 5 years in prison after he implicated others in the plot. He only served 4 months. Sentenced 25 years and served 4 months. Okay, then. Punk rock is a genre of music, fast-paced, shorter songs, heavy-hitting. Apparently begin is just a word there. I'm pretty sure it's not, yeah. Reagan? Ronald Reagan? Ronald Wilson Reagan was an American politician who served as the 40th president of the United States. Palestine. Officially recognized as the State of Palestine by the United Nations and other entities, is a sovereign state in Western Asia claiming the West Bank and Gaza Strip with Jerusalem as the designated capital, although its administrative center is currently located in Ramallah. Terror on the airline. Alright. This was when terrorist hijacking kind of started, I guess. Ayatollahs in Iran. So before we had people in other places, now we've got this. Okay, let's see. Alright, he was an Iranian politician, revolutionary, and cleric, apparently. That's interesting. Russians in Afghanistan. People moving from one place to another. Very interesting. Wheel of Fortune, famous game show, Sally Ride. Who is Sally Ride? My voice is getting hoarse. Sally Kirsten Ride was an American astronaut and physicist born in Los Angeles. She joined NASA in 1978 and became the first American woman in space in 1983. Ride was the third woman in space overall after USSR cosmonauts Valentina somebody and Svetlana Zavitskaya. Yeah, all right. Heavy metal, genre of music, very powerful. Suicide. All right, I'm pretty sure suicide was around before this time period, but whatever. He's just saying things that were happening. And it's probably true that it started going up. Foreign debts, so debts to foreign powers. Homeless vets. All right, veterans that have no home. AIDS. A disease. Very horrible disease. Crack. Drugs. Bernie Goetz? Whatever. He was an American vigilante who rose to national fame when he shot... Okay, then. That's horrifying. He was acquitted of attempted murder, but was found guilty of illegal firearms possession. Weird. So this man just shot 4 people? 4 African-American males on a New York City subway train. And he was acquitted of attempted murder. He was found guilty of illegal firearms possession. That is... Oh, and he's, according to this, he's still alive. Interesting. All right. Hypodermics on the shores. An environmental disaster during 1987 to 88 in Connecticut, New Jersey, and New York, where significant amounts of medical waste, including hypodermic syringes and raw garbage, washed up onto beaches in the Jersey Shore, New York City, and on Long Island. That is horrible. And... makes you wonder what, yeah. China's under martial law. Tiananmen Square protests, yes. During 1989 Tiananmen Square protests in Beijing, the Chinese People's Liberation Army played a decisive role in enforcing martial law, suppressing the demonstrations by force, and upholding the authority of the Chinese Communist Party. What authority, I may ask? All right, rock and roller cola wars. The Coca-Cola Company and PepsiCo. Okay, had a war. I can't take it anymore. We didn't start the fire. It's burning on and 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 on. All right.
That was a fun song. That was fun.
Okay. So that was Billy Joel, We Didn't Start the Fire, and that is every single reference in the song explained. And also a reaction to the song. Hope this utterly random video that probably was painful to watch. Who knows? Let me know what you think. It's okay. It's okay. It was painful to make, so it was probably painful to watch too. I have no idea. But still, interesting to learn all that. I'm going to listen to the song again after I hit stop recording. And yeah, there's so much going on in this song. Like, it's all talk. Like, he doesn't stop singing the whole time. Na 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 na. I can't take it anymore. We didn't start the fire. Na 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 na. That's such a fun song. All right. If you're new here and you're still watching, yeah, please subscribe to the channel, because I put a lot of work into these videos and I really appreciate it. All right. And, yeah. Thank you for watching. Thank you for spending some time with me. According to YouTube, I just recently passed 200 videos on my channel in total. Or this might be the 200th. I'm not sure. Something like that. And yeah, let me know what else you'd like me to react to. Deathstroke 9 out.